Messy on the Light, October 20th, 2018, letter number 63. Is death immortal? Revelations of Jesus Christ through John the Apostle. In the end, only death is immortal. Yes, for now, only death is immortal, and this is not going to be forever. Jesus will destroy death forever. He came down to earth for that purpose by giving up His earthly life. For us, He bought an everlasting life for everyone. In His promise, He assured us that was the only way. The Lord Jesus, along with Father, prime creator, they had made everything new in heaven and awaiting our arrival. Revelations 21, verses 1 through 4. And I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adored for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and He will dwell with them, and they shall be His people, and God Himself shall be with them and be their God. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. Jesus performed the rise of the dead miracles, so the people of those times can believe, also to be recorded from the holy apostles, so the rest of the generations who will come in later times have a knowledge till we reunite with Him in the second coming. What a great emotion for the widow who her only child raised from the dead, her little son who was the only other person in her life. The Lord with the apostles were passing through there. They heard the screamings and the cries of the widowed mother. The Lord bent from His emotions and He moved. With a great authority He stands by the dead child's bed and He said, Young man, I am talking to you, get up. At once the dead child got up and started talking. Think about the praises those people who witnessed this miracle felt for God and Jesus. In the beginning, they felt fear, but it was understandable, the fear they felt because they were not seeing such a thing in their daily lives. Yet, as they saw this great miracle, they felt that God visited their city and Jesus came to earth to save His people. Luke 7, verses 11 through 16. Closely follow this, He traveled to a city called Nain, and His disciples and a great crowd were traveling with Him. As He got near the gate of the city, why look, there was a dead man being carried out, the only begotten son of His mother. Besides, she was a widow. A considerable crowd from the city was also with her. And when the Lord got sight of her, He was moved with pity for her and He said to her, Stop weeping. With that, He approached and touched the bier, and the bearer stood still, and He said, Young man, I say to you, get up. And the dead man sat up and started to speak, and He gave him to his mother. Now fear seized them all, and they began to glorify God, saying, A great prophet has been raised us among us, and God has turned His attention to His people. The rise of the dead is a strange event for the mortal people. It causes fear like the empty tomb of the Lord's. The angel told the woman not to fear. But they left the tomb with them to meet with the others in fear, as they did not believe their eyes of just what had happened. Perhaps it's not that different, the feeling of death with the eyes of the dead after all. Great fear. Fear because death is not natural, and also the resurrection is not what we have known. Fear of what we can tolerate, and fear what is beyond us. As the resurrection of the widow of the city Nain is important to see that the fear subsides with the praise, with praises to God. They saw that not only God remembered them, but he visited them also. He broke the chain of death from total end. He made death sleep. This is clearly on the next resurrection of our Lord, did to the daughter of Jairus. As they were congregating, Jairus came and fell on his knees in front of Jesus and begged him to come to his house immediately, because his 12 years old daughter was about to die. As they were walking, the people approached them and said it was too late, the girl had died already. But Jesus did not arrive. But Jesus did arrive and told all the ones in the room to stop crying, because the girl is not dead, but she sleeps. Luke 8, 40 and 42. When Jesus got up, the crowd receiving him kindly, for they were all expecting him. But look, a man named Jairus came to his man, to this man, was a presenting officer of the synagogue, and he fell at the feet of Jesus and began to entreat him to enter into his house, because he had an only begotten daughter about 12 years old, and she was dying. And he was going, as he was going, the crowd thronged him. And also Luke 8:49 and 56. While he was yet speaking, a certain representative of the presiding officer of the synagogue came, saying, "Your daughter has died. Do not bother the teacher any longer." On hearing this, Jesus answered him, "Have no fear, only put forth faith, and she will be saved." When he reached the house, he did not let anyone go in with him except Peter and John and James and the girl's father and mother. But people were all weeping and beating themselves in grief for her. So he said, "Stop weeping, for she did not die, but she's sleeping." At this, they began to laugh at him scornfully. Because they knew she had died. But he took her by the hand and called, saying, "Girl, get up." And her spirit returned to her, and she rose instantly, and he ordered something to be given her to eat. Well, her parents were beside themselves, but he instructed them to tell no one that had what had happened. Apostle Luke is the only one who had saved some of these events with resurrections. If we see the things on the surface for sure, the resurrection of the dead is the greatest. But if we search deeper, the greatest miracle is the repentance of the sins. In the case of the physical resurrection, the body comes to life again, but later on in life will die. In the case of repentance of the sinner, the entire soul resurrects from the total death of sin, because later this person will have everlasting life. Only then we can taste the true fruits of the resurrection, self-resurrected by being obedient to our Lord, self-resurrected with hot prayers and gratitude for the Lord and God. We are resurrecting ourselves with constant teaching of his divine word. We are resurrecting ourselves when we are compassionate to others and we show affection to all. So, in comparing, the resurrection of the body is totally different from the resurrection of the soul, which will happen to the second coming of our Lord. It will be the fulfillment of our participation and devotion with Him. The constant repentance is our first resurrection. John speaks to us about this in Revelation 20, verse 5. The rest of the dead did not come to life until the 1,000 years were over. This is the first resurrection. My beloveds, the final death of the human, apart from God on the second coming, won't threaten no one of the people who live here and now. They are striving for the first resurrection. In this way, we will never, ever be apart from God. The written words and the promises of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Amen.